Hello students. In the last session we have discussed about virtual memory address translation techniques, memory allocation techniques. So in this session we are going to discuss about cache memory and the address mapping techniques. So as we are aware that the cache memory is the fastest memory compared to the main memory. It is placed in between the CPU and main memory. Small amount of fast memory sits between the normal main memory and CPU. It may be located on the CPU chip or module. If we consider the working of the cache memory, CPU initially looks in the cache for the data it needs. If the data is there, it will retrieve it and process it. If data is not there, then the CPU accesses the system memory and puts a copy of the new data in the cache before processing it. Next time, if the CPU needs to access the same data again, it will just retrieve the data from the cache instead of going through the whole loading process again. So this is the organization representing the single cache and three level cache organization. In between CPU and cache, there is a word transfer. In between the cache and main memory, block transfer has been performed. So block transfer is slower compared to the word transfer. If we consider the cache organization, figure shows the principal components of the cache. Memory words are stored in a cache data memory and are grouped into a small pages which are called cache blocks or lines. The contents of the cache data memory are thus copies of set of main memory blocks. Each cache block is marked with its block address referred to as tag. So the cache knows to what part of the memory space the block belongs. Collection of the tag addresses currently assigned to the cache, which can be non-contiguous. So it is stored in a special memory which is called cache tag memory. So cache data which holds the memory words and cache tag which holds the space at which the block belongs. So this is about the cache organization in which the cache consists of number of blocks and the tag information, and it consists of number of lines. As main memory consists of blocks with k words. So we are going to consider two designs of cache. First is lookaside design of cache. So in case of lookaside design of cache, cache and main memory are directly connected to the system bus. In this design, CPU initiates the memory access by placing a real address AI on the memory address bus at the start of a read or write cycle. The cache M1 immediately compares AI with the tag addresses currently residing in its tag memory. If the match is found in M1, that is the cache hit, the access is completed by a read or write operation executed in the cache. So here the main memory M2 is not involved. If there is no match with AI is formed, then cache miss occurs. So coming to the second design, which is look through cache. So in case of look through cache, CPU communicates with the cache via separate bus that is isolated from the main system bus. The system bus is available for use by the other units such as IO controllers in order to communicate with the main memory. So hence, cache accesses and main memory accesses not involving the CPU can proceed concurrently. So if we consider the caches and locality of reference, cache is placed in between the processor and memory. It makes large slow main memory appear fast. Effectiveness is based on some measure which is called locality of reference. So locality of reference is nothing but a typical program behavior which involves executing the instructions in loops and accessing the array data. So we are going to consider two types of locality of reference. First is temporal locality and second is spatial locality. Temporal locality is the instructions or data that have been recently accessed are likely to be again. Spatial locality, where the nearby instructions or data are likely to be accessed after the current access. If we consider the cache operations are in terms of read and write hits and read or write misses. So processor issues read and write request as if it were accessing the main memory directly. If the desired information is present in the cache, a read or write hit occurs. For a read hit, main memory is not involved. Cache provides the desired information. For a write hit, we are having two approaches, so that we'll consider later. More cache concepts. So to exploit the spatial locality, transfer the cache block with multiple adjacent words from memory. So we are going to consider the mapping function, which determines where the block from the memory is to be located in the cache. When the cache is full, replacement algorithm determines which block to remove for the space. How to handle the cache writes? So cache writes are handled by using two types of protocols. First is write-through protocol, in which we are going to update the cache and memory contents. The write-back protocol, in which only updates has been made for the cache and memory updated later when the block is replaced. Write-back scheme needs modified bit to mark the blocks that are updated in the cache. Single memory update is often more efficient even if writing back unchanged ports. Coming to cache misses, how to handle the cache misses. If the desired information is not present in the cache, read or write miss occurs. For a read miss, a block with desired word is transferred from the main memory to the cache. For a write miss, under write-through protocol, the information is written into the main memory. Under a write-back protocol, first transfer the block containing the addressed word into the cache, then overwrite the location in the cached block. So we'll consider different mapping functions. Mapping is about how to locate, how to place the main memory blocks onto the cache lines, cache locations. So three types of mapping functions has been considered. First is direct mapping, second is associative mapping, third is set associative mapping. So the mapping functions use small cache with 128 blocks of 16 words, use main memory with 64K words, word addressable memory, so 16-bit addresses. So here, address mapping is nothing but allocating or placing the main memory blocks onto the cache locations. So depending on the match of the type, we are going to allocate the blocks of the main memory onto the cache locations, cache lines. So direct mapping is considered next. So it is the simplest approach, which uses a fixed mapping where the memory block J mapped onto the cache block J mod 128. So here we'll divide the address into three fields, word, block and tag. Block field determines the location in the cache. Tag field determines the original address stored in the cache compared with latter addresses for hit or miss. So if we consider the example, here we are going to consider the main memory with number of blocks, cache memory with number of lines. So suppose the main memory consists of 64 words, block size is 4 words. So we are going to determine number of blocks in the main memory as 64 divided by 4, that is number of words in the main memory and number of that is block size, so which results in 16 blocks. So if we consider the cache, number of blocks is 16 and lines of cache is determined as 16 divided by 4 words, so which gives 4 lines. So cache consists of 4 lines and blocks consists of, the main memory consists of 16 blocks. So suppose CPU is generating some address. So we need to find the number of words and the location of these words within the cache memory. So for this, we are going to consider the example. Suppose the CPU is generating the address line 6 bits. Suppose the 6 bits are 000101. So it represents word number 5. So we need to consider division of this address into two fields. First 4 bits and second 2 bits. First 4 bits represents the block number and 2 bits represents the offset. So first 4 bits represents the block number and second represents the block offset. So 0001 represents the block number 1. And 01, which is nothing but second location in the main memory. 00 is the first location and 01 is the second location. So within this, we are going to randomly place the words 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 in the main memory. So here we'll consider fifth word, so which is positioned at the second position with the block number 1. 0001 represents block number 1 and 01 represents the second position. Suppose if we consider 1010. So 1010 represents 10th word with the block number is 2. Block number is 2 and the word number is 10. So it is placed at third location, third memory position. So it is represented by 001010. So 0010 represents the word number 10. So it is divided into two parts, 0010 and 10, block number 2, third location in the main memory. So direct mapping is to find the block that is present in whether the block is present or not present in the cache. If the block is not present, then we need to put into the cache. So mapping is about how to put the blocks into the cache lines, how the blocks in the main memory are mapped onto the cache lines. Suppose if we consider 6 bits in which the first 4 bits represents the block number and 2 bits represents the offset. So if we consider the main memory and the cache, so number of main memory blocks are mapped onto a single line of the cache. So it represents many to one mapping. So here we are going to place the blocks in round robin manner, and the cache represents the numbers in sequential manner 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if we consider these blocks with 0, 0 as the last bits. So 0, 0 represents 0 here. Again 0, 0 represents 4. Again 0, 0 represents the 8 and 12. So this goes to the line number 1 of cache. So suppose 0, 4, 8, 12 represents the 0 line of the cache. 1, 5, 9, 13 represents the first line of the cache. And 2, 6, 10 and 14 represents the second line. 3, 7, 11 and 15 represents the third line. So next we'll consider the tag representation and scenario for allocation of the block. So if we consider the CPU, addresses are represented by tag to be 2 bits, the block number to be 2 bits and block offset to be 2 bits. So 0000 with the offset can be of 4 combinations 0001, 10 and 11. So 00 represents the tag, 00 represents the block number. So block number is 0 and the tag is 0 here, and 00001011. So this represents the 0 word, and 00001. So it represents 1, 2 and 3. So if we consider the example 2, 1101 which represents the word 13 multiplied with 4, that means the number of combinations are now the number of words, so it results in 52. So the first combination represents 52, second represents 53, 54 and 55. So these are mapped onto the second line number of the cache. Similarly for the example 3, 1010 with the offset can be 0001 10 and 11. So it represents the word 10 multiplied with 4, that is 4 words. So it represents 40. The first combination represents 40, second combination represents 41, second next 42, 43. So these are placed onto the second line number of the cache, third line number of the cache, which is associated with the tag 10. So next is 11110010 and 11. So these are represented by 60 61 62 63. So these are placed at the fourth line of the cache representing the tag 11. So these are 00111011. So these represents the tag. So we need to find the number of blocks of the memory are mapped onto the cache depending on the tag information. We need to check for the tag. We need to compare the tag of the main memory with tag of the cache memory. So suppose CPU generates 110101. 11 represents the tag, 01 represents the block number and 01 represents the offset. So again, if you consider the cache memory, 00 is associated with 0 line number, 11 is associated with the line number 1. So here we need to check the tag of the main memory with the tag of the cache. So 11 matches with 11, then with the block number is 01, that is the line number of the cache, that is 1. So here the match is found. If you consider another example, 100111. So here 10 is associated with the second block, second line of the cache, and 01 is the first line. So 10 is not matched with this 10, so the block is not present. So all these are about the direct mapping, that is map.